Young Jeezy, a.k.a. Mr. 17.5, a.k.a. Mr. TM103. You know what I mean? Jizzle, whatever you want to call him. Young, El Jefe, all that. Yeah, if that's why I say the way y'all, the way he had that, yeah. I would use this one, right? And then in post, put the mic, get that length, so it's like that. So it's not like this.
But is the mic gonna look tiny?
But it still be cool, as long as you see it. You know what I'm saying? Because like with that,
right.
This is like fucking this wide. Who does that? So, I'm a thug motivator. No, I do motivational music. I do street music. I do, you know, it's like the street Bible. It's what I preach, you know what I mean? Gospel.
Yeah, you tired, baby?
Yeah, baby. It's almost... You rolling, I'm rolling.
Oh, okay. That sound good. That's a good campaign. You got a good camera conversation. Sound good, player.
TM103 is my fourth studio album. Since I released Thug Motivation 101, which was 5 years ago, and this is 103, so this would be the extension of that, the second half of it. You know, it's, I think it's been like a 5 year gap. I'm just coming straight off the recession, which was one of my greatest albums, and it was definitely somewhat political, and you know, a lot to do with what was going on in the streets. And that was just a part of, you know what I mean, in my life that I felt like I wanted to, you know, be involved with what was going on in the world. And, you know, after I done that, I kind of had to sit down and just live a little bit, you know what I mean, just really do me and not really get caught up in the whole music, you know what I mean, fame thing, and go back to what I do, and which would prepare me for Thug Motivation 103, which is TM103.
Some of that gully shit.
I have everything else whited out, and the only thing black is me and that and that. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That'd be kind of dope. So here I am, and this is how I feel, and this is how I look. That's what, you know, Thug Motivation is about to me. It's about showing people you could be better in a lot of different ways. So the shoot was like that. It just felt good. Like it wasn't no crazy backdrops and nothing like that. We just went to this warehouse and got it in. You know what I mean? I just feel like this was an album for me and the streets. This is our album. You know, normally my albums are just for the streets or just for, you know, the people that I talk to. But this was our album. It was my way of relating to them, or a person, or a cat that's from where you from, and he's on his fourth album. And, you know, he still pretty much has the same mentality. He might change a bit, you know what I mean, for the better, but he still has the same mentality. So basically, I just, you know, went and lived and, you know, doing all the stuff I do. And in the midst of it, I made music.
White this, white that, in my white socks, yeah. Used to have them white bags with my white socks, yeah. This ain't so white, you telling a white lie. Never sold a white name, never seen a white pie.
It was a long process. It probably took me a little longer with this album than it done with any of my albums, because I had to reset. You know, I had to kind of go back and see who I really was and how I really feel about things and what did I really want to say. Man, it's been a minute, you know, a year and some change, but you know, we're finally here.
So, back again, Taj, director of Jeezy's All White Everything. More wind. I want to see like the tails of her hair flowing in the back, like that. So more wind. There you go. Cut, start over.
Yo, Taj, he dope. You know what I mean? And me and him kind of work well together. This is probably one of my most creative bodies of work. You know what I mean? One of my more emotional bodies of work. You know what I mean? And it just brought me all to this point. It's about that time to get it to the world. I put Lose My Mind out, you know, All White. Those are my type of records. Like, I didn't do that for radio. I ain't do that for nobody but me. Because that's what I like, and I know how that connects. You know, even when you get to this level of success, you still deal with the demons, and you still deal with the trials and the trills. You still deal with people. For the most part, I think I got what I wanted out the video, and the girls was kind of all right, too. So it worked all out, you know what I mean?
Westside! What's up, Playboy?
Other than that, you know, we gotta just pretty much put the music out and hit the road. Like, do what I do.
It's all G Car.
You know, I sat back for a minute and got myself back very focused, you know what I mean? And just got on that determination path and was just, every day was a constant grind for me So, you know, just really, you know, get myself together as far as eating better and just, you know what I'm saying, doing better things with my life, but I'm still had the same mentality.
Ain't playing nobody nothing. Yeah. Well, I know you from though, guy. Yeah, we was in the studio. Yeah, so what?
I know a lot of people from a lot of different facets of life, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of people just kind of know me, you know what I mean? Whether it was some of the OGs, some of the homies around me. In Atlanta, just, you know, we respect hustlers. If you're a hustler, you know, whatever it is that you do, you know, we support. Because when you're hustling, you move forward. And people know that if you're a great hustler, you can always move forward. So it's always good to be affiliated or, you know, be one of your acquaintances or whatever.
You know, I think that he's making good music right now. And I'm just out here showing some love and showing support. He likes sports and I love rap. So, I mean, I guess it goes together.
Yeah. They get it, Charlotte. Yeah. I'm ready to go. We got woke up, baby.
At the end of the day, it's like we kind of all know each other because everybody kind of went through the same ranks.
What's up, nigga? Oh, yeah? You got 16 balls or something, motherfucker?
My progression was is crazy because, you know what I'm saying, I had to step back and see who I was. You know what I mean? They obviously, you could take a cat out of the hood, but you can't take the hood out of them. You know, and even when I was in the hood, you know what I'm saying, I was always, you know, 10 steps ahead of them. So I just felt like, you know, I had to kind of, you know, still be that way now. You know what I mean? And as far as me, I feel like I'm a lot more advanced than a lot of these guys that are in this game because they didn't come from, the path of life that I came from. And I understand trials and trails. I understand pressure. I understand, you know, when it's time to go, it's go time. I know how to get back. You know what I mean? Why I just left. It's not a problem. I've been doing it all my life. And I had to kind of see that. And that was my progression. Like, you Jeezy. Like, you, like, what are they going to tell you? You know what I mean? You already beat the worst. This rap shit is cake and ice cream. Like, for real. Sweet. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Especially when you're the best at what you do. So at the end of the day, you know, I just had to find myself. You know what I mean? I had to catch up with where I was, you know what I'm saying, as far as how long I've been on this earth and my mentality. It's like, I don't have to do a lot of the other things. I already done it. That's crazy. Like, why the fuck am I already been to Vietnam? Why am I going back? Let them go. They fight that battle. You know what I'm saying? I'm a veteran now. You know what I mean?